Hi all, welcome to WSO2 API Microgateway 3.0 tutorial on Quick Start. I am Rajit Roshan from WSO2 API Manager team. First of all, let me briefly explain the architecture of WSO2 API Microgateway. It has two basic components, the gateway runtime and the gateway toolkit. So the toolkit accepts OpenAPI definitions and create microgateway projects and later build microgateway runtime artifacts that are used by the microgateway runtime component. So you can download the toolkit from WSO2 API Microgateway site. This toolkit is a command line interface to manage your microgateway projects. So we can initialize microgateway projects with standard OpenAPI definitions, and later these projects can be built to create runtime artifacts for runtime containers or the binary distributions, or you can generate Kubernetes artifacts which you can deploy in Kubernetes cluster. And also you can import APIs from WSO2 API Manager using the toolkit as well. So now let me demonstrate how you can expose the services using Microgateway using the OpenAPI definitions. So I have two services running on my Kubernetes cluster. I am going to expose those two Kubernetes services using a standard OpenAPI definition using Microgateway. So you can see that book list and book search services are in my Kubernetes cluster. So I'm going to expose these two services using Microgateway. First of all, let me initialize the Microgateway project. The command is Microgateway init the project name. I'm going to specify bookstore as my project name. So you can see the project is initiated successfully. Let me do a tree command and show the project structure. So API definitions folder is the folder where we need to put the OpenAPI definitions. And deployment config.toml has deployment related configurations related to Docker and Kubernetes. And also by default, we support Fuse extensions as well. An interceptor folder is where we need to put custom written code whenever we need transformations. And policies YAML specify the throttle policies. And services like authorize endpoint, revoke endpoint are proxy services to connect to your key manager component. So now let me copy my OpenAPI definition to API definitions folder of my project. So I'm going to copy my OpenAPI definition. So let me open the API definition inside my project. So this is a basic OpenAPI definition which exposes listing and searching functionalities using the Swagger file. So in order to expose this via a Microgateway, we need to specify vendor specific OpenAPI extensions. So the first extension we need is to specify the base path in which this API is exposed. So I'm going to give the base path as /bookstore/v1. So I'm going to specify, then you can see there are two microservices. So I'm going to specify production endpoints for those two services. So the vendor extension for that is xwso2 production endpoints. So we can specify multiple URLs as production endpoint. Here I'm going to specify my production service running on Kubernetes cluster. So my IP is and I'm going to specify the port in which my service is running. So I have specified the production endpoint for my listing services, and I'm going to do the same for my search service as well. So I'm going to give the correct port for my search service. So now we can see how you have extend your standard OpenAPI definition using Microgateway related vendor extensions. Now I am going to save this file and I am going to build this microgateway project to generate the runtime artifacts. So the command is microgateway build the project name. So we can see that it now building the microgateway project and the executables are generated inside the target folder. So we can provide these executables to the runtime component. So the runtime is the component which serves the actual request coming. It applies security, rate limiting, transformation, analytics, and many more functionalities. So this runtime is available as a binary distribution as well as Docker images as well. So this runtime runs on top of artifact generated by the toolkit component. So now you have seen how we can create the runtime artifact. Let's see how we can provide these runtime artifacts to a Docker microgateway Docker runtime component and how we can invoke these APIs. So I'm going to use the WSO2 API microgateway Docker image. So the command to export to provide these runtime artifacts is Docker. I'm going to mount this target folder to my Docker container. So command is minus V, and inside the container I'm going to specify /home/exec, and I'm going to expose the 9090 ports to the outside, and which is the HTTP port, and 9095 ports as well, and I need to specify the project name as environment variable. So the project name is bookstore. I'm going to use WSO2 microgateway Docker image, and I'm going to use the latest version 3.01. So this is the basic command to expose the runtime artifacts using the Docker container. So let's see whether our Docker container is up and running. So my Docker container is up and running. So let's see how I can invoke these services exposed via my Docker container. I need to get a valid token in order to invoke these services. So let me quickly get a token from WSO2 API manager in order to invoke these services. So I have a application which gives me a JWT token. So I'm going to generate a JWT token, and I'm going to use that token to invoke my services. So I have set the token to the command line, and I'm going to invoke my books listing service using the token. So we can see that books listing service has responded successfully, and I'm going to test my search service as well. So the endpoint is search and the search query. I'm going to specify a keyword to search. So we can see that my search service also has responded. So this is basically how you can expose your APIs using the open API definition using the micro gateway. So these are the upcoming tutorials where we explain how to deploy micro gateway in Kubernetes and how you can use etcd server for service discovery for micro gateway, and apply security for using this open API definitions using O2, JWT and basic code. And we will show you how to enable mutual SSL for microgateway, and we can demonstrate the application of microgateway in microservices architecture, and how to validate the schema, microgateway schema validation using the open API definition provided, and on the fly transformation with interceptors, and also microgateway local and distributed throttling and JWT revocation as well. So these will be the upcoming tutorials of microgateway. So thank you for joining